right. Hello and welcome, everybody. So here's an idea. And we should do this more. Whenever we're creating conference talk titles, even if we're doing them from our house, inject lots of ambiguity into your title. You can't read this and understand what I'm going to talk about. Is no plan worse, or is no plan worse? I don't know. So I'm Brian Lyles. I work at VMware, not in this whole Tanzu world, but actually in telco. And I wanted to talk about planning. Nope. So to get started, let's actually raise a scenario. We're going on a trip. And when we go on a trip, there's something that we need to do. Well, we need to plan an itinerary. We need to book travel. And we need to pack luggage. But there's also something that we need to do that, you know what, escapes people sometimes. We need to ask some very important questions. Why are we going? When are we going? Who is going? And I'm sure if we sat and thought about this some more, we could actually think of some other questions we should ask. Now, why is this important? Well, what it comes down to is that the journey, whenever we're taking a journey, is a vehicle to get you to a destination. And the reason why we ask why, when, and where are we going is because we're thinking about packing, when we're thinking about what we're going to plan, when we're thinking about the actual vehicle that we should actually use to get to our destination. If I'm going to Hawaii, I probably can take a plane. But because I live in DC and I'm going to Virginia, I could take a car. Or, you know what, I could ride a bike. Or I could walk. So it is very important to not just think about the journey, but to think about the destination. And as I tie this into the conference at hand, really, let me change the statement here. The journey is actually a plan to get you to a goal. And now, you know, it seems that we've come out of the abstract, and where we are is something that's a little bit more concrete, but we're still at a pretty high level. So let's dig in a little bit more. So let's think about, first of all, how do we plan? And a lot of you now are thinking, well, you know, we get with our project manager or our manager and we do iteration planning. And then, you know, we decide, we have a backlog maybe, and we decide what we're going to do for our sprint, 2 weeks, 3 weeks, 4 weeks, 6 weeks. I don't know. But you know what? That's not what I'm here to talk about, because that's, you know, that's superficial. And let's actually think about this concept of planning. And what we need to do before we start thinking about planning is we need to understand what. And what is, well, what are we actually doing here? So if we're in DevOps land, what are we doing? Well, we are, you know, we're managing some piece of software that needs to go in production. We're automatically scaling. We're increasing resiliency. We're doing things like thinking about observability. We're looking at the manageability and all the rest of the abilities that we would actually need to have something something that is viable. But now there's another circle here where we got to think about how. And we think about how are these tools, or how could be the tools that we're going to use. And, you know, I can probably spend more than the 6 minutes and 20 seconds I have left listing off all the tools that I know in this space. But if we think about it, how are we going to do what we're going to do? What we need to do. So if we're collecting metrics, you know, the nicest tool that I can think of right now is something that is Prometheus back. If we're thinking about how we're going to deliver our software and, you know, accurately and consistently and reliably, you know, I'm thinking about my continuous delivery process. If I'm ensuring that my software doesn't have any bugs or regressions, you know, I'm thinking about my integration process. But the most important piece is why. And this is something that we forget about when we're actually planning. We always think about the how or the what we need to do. Sometimes we think about the how, but we often forget about the why. Why do my site need to be resilient? Why do I need to understand what's going on? Why do I want to do this in an automated fashion? Is it because of I'm in a secure environment? Is it because that humans are like a plague and they actually break everything they touch by design? I don't know. But we need to understand the why before we get into the what. And this is called the Golden Circle, by the way. I didn't invent this comet, this picture. There was a nice fellow named Simon Sinek who actually has written many thousands of words about this topic. But I think about this a lot when I'm thinking about planning. So next, I want to actually apply how I think about planning. So the first thing we need to do is we need to have a vision. And I'll go into what the vision is, but just keep that in mind. And then we need to have goals. And we go from goals and we go into strategy or strategies, depending on how you look at the world. And then finally, you need to go into tactics. And now let me actually go backwards and explain why this is important. So planning and DevOps. And, you know, I want to give a little shout out to myself because the first iteration of these slides, it said DevOps. Because I think when I was running KubeCon, we actually had a conference that ran side by side with us that was called DevOps. So that stuck in my head. So I don't call it DevOps anymore. I call it DevOps. But really, in this case, when we're thinking about tactics are your tools. So if we're thinking about tooling in our space, you know, I have some examples here. I have Ansible and GitHub and Terraform or Prometheus or Kubernetes or any other of the myriad tools that we could actually use. This is what we are actually doing. And then we need to think about strategies. Strategies here are the idea of, you know, this is what I'm going to do to get me to my next level. And so here I have three examples, but this, like the last one here, it is continuously deploy applications because humans are a plague. And then finally, we have the goals. And these are the milestones for the project. These say what we need to do to actually be successful. And in this case, I said users to search for widgets because I have a widget store. And then finally, we have the vision. The vision is where you want to go. And we want to create the best widget store. So if I took these around and I think about it again, we have a vision. A vision says where we want to be. It's the destination. It's when we're taking the trip. You know, we can't answer the questions unless we know where we want to be, what time we want to be there. And yes. So then you think about the goals. So the goals, if we're applying it back to our trip, the goals are what we want to do whenever we are going, whenever we get to our destination. These are the things I want to do. I want to go to Hawaii. So what I want to do, I want to be able to go surfing. So if I think about going surfing, what I need to do is I think about the strategies for that. Well, if I want to go surfing, I need to think, well, do I want to go in the morning or do I want to go in the evening? And then down to the tactics level, I think I need a surfboard and a wetsuit. And actually for me, I need to know how to surf. I actually don't know how to do that either. And maybe I need some shark repellent. So what's next? So this is where, you know, I can get all existential and say, here's how we can make the world better. But I'm actually not going to do that. What's next? Really, here's the problem that we have. We have it in DevOps land. We have it in dev land. We have it in ops land. We have it in the real world. We spend way more time talking about the journey than the destination. We talk about the cool new tools. I can go into Twitter right now and search for Kubernetes, and 3/4 of the tweets will be about the hate. People are upset with Kubernetes. And you know why? Is it because it's a bad tool? No, that's actually not true. Yeah, it's hard to use because it's super complex. It's an operating system. It's a platform for creating platforms. But you know what the problem is? The problem is that people are using Kubernetes, that tactic, because they don't have a strategy. And if they have a strategy, they don't have any goals. And if they have goals, they don't have a vision. You can't get to where you can't describe. So when we start thinking about what's next, what do we need to do? And you're stuck. Figure out where you are. Do you have a vision? Do you have goals? Do you have strategy? Do you have tactics? And if you don't have any of those, you know, work through that little chain, and that's how you decide what's next. And I'm going to leave it here because I only had 10 minutes, but I just want to say thank you for listening today. And I'm happy to be able to share this. I'm done.